Connector's Cinema 4D integration received a massive update, which turned it into the most advanced integration, on par with the 3DS Max. Let's look at the major new features that are making their way in with version 2. First up is the ability to generate custom previews from within Connector. All you need to do is to set up a dedicated instance. If you have multiple versions of Cinema 4D, it's a good idea to use the latest to evade compatibility issues. Next, right-click a few Cinema 4D assets and select Generate Custom Previews. You need to download or add studios in order to use this feature. Let's get some from the ones that are offered within Connector. You can pick between studios prepared for V-Ray and Corona Renderer. If you are using a different engine, you have the option to edit the studios after they are downloaded or add your own ones. It's a good idea to download a few different studios and experiment to find out which are the best fit for your assets. When you hit the Generate button, the assets you've selected will be rendered in the selected studio using the dedicated Cinema 4D instance. You can open the previews generation queue and observe the process. It's very helpful if there are issues with the generation. You will get errors that will help you fix the problems. Now, let's generate custom previews using different studios for the furniture and the accessories. As you can see, you can run the tool in batches, picking and choosing the assets and studios. They will be rendered in the background and won't stop you from working. We will use a third studio for the sofa, as it's a much bigger object. Of course, there are universal studios like the pure white one, but they don't look that good. Depending on your hardware and the amount of assets, the preview generation process can take substantial time. In our case, we jump to the nearby cafe for a hot cappuccino. You can continue working while the rendering happens in the background or leave the process through the night. The second big new feature is the support of proxies. Initially, Connector offers support for V-Ray and Corona Renderer proxies, with more to come in the future. When you drag and drop a Cinema 4D asset in the software viewport, you have the option to merge as proxy object. Then, all you have to do is adjust its settings before it's generated. By default, the proxy type is automatically detected, but you can pick it manually. You can also select where to save the proxy that will be created and specify its naming pattern. After hitting the merge button, a proxy will be created in the specified folder. You can interact with the proxy object and place it, just like with the normal merge and place feature. Let's drop a resting porcelain cat because a bedroom is not finished without such an accessory. You can see that the two proxies appear in the object manager, so you can easily organize them. Generate custom previews and merge as proxy object are the main new features in version 2 of the Cinema 4D integration. There are lots of other changes, so make sure you check the links in the description for more information. Follow our channel for more guides and tips about Connector.